the 13th meeting of the Honolulu Liquor Commission. Commissioners, I believe that's a minutes to approve.
Yes, Chair. Motion to approve the regular and executive session minutes of the 20th and the 23rd meetings as previously circulated.
Second.
It's been moved in second to approve the regular and executive session minutes of the 20th and the 23rd meetings as previously circulated. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, Chair votes aye. The regular and executive session minutes of the 20th and 23rd meetings are approved. Going into public hearing, calling agenda item number 1, application number 22-23818 from Holly Eva Distilling Company, LLC. Ms. Oceana.
Good afternoon, Madam Chair, members of the Commission, Mia Oceana on behalf of the applicant. I believe this hearing has been rescheduled till March, I believe it's the 14th or the 27th, if we could continue this until that time.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, you just need to continue to that date and keep public hearing open.
Which date would you like? Yeah.
March.
I believe the hearing was rescheduled for March. Either it was the 17th or the 24th. I don't recall, Madam Administrator, do you have that?
Actually, I don't. I have no information from the licensing section about the rescheduling. I did notice that the letter was not in your packet. But
in the file, there's a letter that we sent to the
Okay,
field.
Hold on. Yeah. March 24.
March 24. Okay, hold on, Ms. Oceana. We're going to, Ms. Harai.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you. In this instance, I guess all you need to do is confirm that there is no one appearing at the meeting that wishes to provide testimony. If not, you can go ahead and continue the matter to March 24th, leaving the public hearing open.
Commissioners, step up action.
A motion to continue agenda item number 1. To March 24th, public hearing kept open.
Second.
It's been moved in second to continue agenda item number 1 to 3/24/2022, public hearing kept open. Any objections? Any with reservation? Seeing none, Chair votes aye. Agenda item number 1 will be continued to March 24/2022, public hearing kept open. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, moving on to agenda item number 2. Application number 22-23932 from Lady Hub Bakery. Mr. Luke.
Good afternoon. All right, is that your choice? Is the general manager? She's President of Council Wayne Luke. We have no changes to the investigator's report.
Thank you. Ms. Harai.
Thank you, Madam Chair and Commissioners. This application has received 0 written protests, 0 letters in support. Applicant has met statutory requirements for the submission of this application.
Motion to approve application number 22-23932.
Second.
It's been moved in second to approve application number 22-23932. Any objections? Any with reservations? Seeing none, Chair votes aye. Application number 22-23932 is approved. Thank you, Mr. Luke.
Thank
you. Okay, going into preliminary, calling agenda item number 3. Application number 21-23417 from Lady Hub Bakery.
Sorry, is it possible to
Okay, let the record reflect that Vice Chair Lee will be recused from agenda item number 3. Mr. Luke, go ahead.
We have no changes to the investigator's report. We have them operating on their temporary license without any problems.
Okay. Commissioners, any questions for Mr. Luke or Ms. Choi?
Motion to approve application number 21-23417.
Second.
It's been moved and second to approve application number 21-23417. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, Chair votes aye. Application 21-23417 is approved. Thank you, Mr. Luke. Okay, can we get Vice Chair Lee? Okay, calling agenda item number four, application number 22-23526 from Adson Cars LLC.
Good afternoon, members of the commission. My name is Alexander Belyaev, affiliate agent of Edson Cars LLC, DBA Booth.
Commissioners, any questions or type of action?
I'll just go ahead and confirm that your supplemental information was distributed to the commission.
Yeah, we're just reading through it for a second. Motion to approve application number 22-23526.
Second.
It's been moved and second to approve application number 22-23526. Any objection? Any with reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. Application number 22-23526 is approved. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
We'll see you at the public hearing. Yeah.
Okay, calling agenda item number five, application number 22-23587 from Hulong LLC. Ms. Lin, please introduce yourself for the record.
My name is Yoko Lin.
Ms. Lin, do you have a copy of the investigative report? Any changes to your application since you submitted?
I had an updated exhibit. Mm-hmm.
Which exhibit is that?
Exhibit A that includes the outdoor seating area to be including the extra 100 square foot.
Exhibit A or B?
It was exhibit B, but the updated version is called exhibit A.
The
right side, there is enough in the floor plan. So the new lease is just that matches the floor plan.
Okay, is that an email from you on February 3rd with pictures? Is that the current, is that what you're referring to?
Yes, but the updated one I submitted.
It's sounding like you don't have it.
Okay, we don't have it, but since we're at preliminary, I guess we can reserve questioning if we have any questions on your updated exhibit.
Motion to approve application number 22-23587.
Second.
It's been moved and second to approve application number 22-23587. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. Application number 22-23587 is approved. Thank you. Okay, moving on to temp licenses. Agenda item number six, application number 22-24126 from PF Chang's China Bistro. Mr. Lee.
Thank you, Chair. Good afternoon, members. Harry Lee, counsel for the applicant. I reviewed the investigative report.
Thank you. Commissioners, any questions for Mr. Lee or type of action?
Motion to approve application number 22-24126.
Second.
It's been moved in second to approve application number 22-24126. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, Chair votes aye. Application is approved, Mr. Lee. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Moving on to request, agenda item number 7, request number 22-24386 on behalf of Surf Bar LLC, Mr. Zabakalan.
Emmanuel Zibakalam here on behalf of Surf Bar LLC. Additionally, we have Nikolaj Pelkin, who's joining us via Zoom. That's spelled N-I-K-O-L-A-J, P-E-L-K-I-N. And I can speak to this request at the commission's request.
Okay. Any questions for Mr. Zibakalan or his client or type of action?
What used to be there? I believe it had a couple different spots before. One was a restaurant, one was a dispenser.
This is in Waikiki, correct?
Correct.
Okay. Motion to approve request number 22-24386.
Second.
It's been moved and second to approve request number 22-24386. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, Chair votes aye. Request number 22-24386 is approved. Thank you, Mr. Zabaka.
Thank you, Chair. Vice Chair, members of the Commission.
Thank you. Okay. Commissioner.
Chair, motion for the acceptance of plea and adoption of decision in order for agenda 8.
Second.
Eight. Okay. Back there.
Order for agenda item number 8. Any objections? Any with reservations? Seeing none, Chair votes aye. The acceptance of the adoption of decision and order for agenda item number 8 is approved.
And Chair, motion to approve the adoption of findings of fact, decision, and order for agenda items 9 through 15 inclusive.
Second.
It's been moved and second to approve the adoption of finding of fact and decision and order for agenda items 9 through 15. Any objections? Any with reservations? Seeing none, Chair votes aye. Adoption of findings and fact, decision and order for agenda items 9 through 15 are approved. Going into the adjudication hearings, calling the first item up for, Mr. Jacob, go ahead.
Good afternoon, Chair, members of the Commission, Daniel Jacob, Deputy Corporation Counsel on behalf of the City.
Okay. Going into adjudications, we're calling agenda item number 16, Beer Lab Hawaii, Mr. Wong.
Please introduce yourself for the record.
Hi, Nicholas Wong, Beer Lab Hawaii.
Thank you.
Owner.
Go ahead, Mr. Jacob.
On or about September 25th, 2021, in the City and County of Honolulu, State of Hawaii, licensee failed to comply with any other laws applicable to the business of licensee, whether in existence at the time of issue of such license or enacted or amended from time to time thereafter, to wit, proclamation and emergency order number 2021-13, COVID-19 novel coronavirus, dated September 17, 2021, in violation of section 281-38 of the Hawaii Revised Statutes.
Mr. Wong, how would you like to plead?
No contest.
Motion to accept the no contest plea for agenda item 16.
Second.
It's been moved and second to accept the no contest plea for agenda item number 16. Any objections? Any with reservations? Seeing none, Chair votes aye. The no contest plea is accepted.
Mr. Jacob.
This violation occurred on September 25th, 2021. Investigators found that the licensee failed to check vaccine statuses of the individuals who are coming to the facility. This is a first violation for the licensee. The recommended fine is $500.
Mr. Wong, any comment?
No comment.
Okay, thank you. Motion to approve the recommended fine of $500.
Second.
It's been moved and second to approve the recommended fine of $500 for agenda item number 16. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, Chair votes aye. The $500 penalty will be imposed for agenda item 16. Thank you, Mr. Wong.
Thank you.
Okay, moving into agenda item number 7, Buho Cocina Y Cantina. Mr. Kiyuchi.
Good afternoon, Madam Chair. Members of the Commission, Mr. Kiyuchi for the YCC. We would waive reading the charge and receive no contest.
Motion to accept the no contest plea for agenda item 17.
Second.
It's been moved in second to approve the no contest plea for agenda item number 17. Any objections? Any with reservation? Seeing none, chair votes aye. No contest plea is accepted.
Mr. Jacob, your recommendation?
This violation occurred on September 1st, 2017, where the licensee sold, advertised, and offered to sell bottomless margaritas for $30. This is licensee's first violation of this type. The recommended fine is $1,000.
Mr. Kiyuchi.
If you look at the date of the violation, this is a while back, 4.5 years ago. It's under the previous owner, and the present owner, I spoke about it, the previous owner had come to this from another establishment in Waikiki, and the present owner has no intention of doing anything like this.
When did the present owner take over the business?
He took it over last year. We've still got a pending transfer with the licensing investigator that has not yet been approved.
All right, and I'm guessing that this bottomless margaritas special has been canceled or was canceled shortly after the violation occurred?
Yeah, I think when they got the citation, they stopped doing it. I've been doing work for Google for a while, and they didn't inform me of the citation being issued, but nevertheless, I had a long talk with the president.
Motion to approve the recommended fine of $1,000.
Second.
It's been moved and second to approve the recommended fine of $1,000 for agenda item number 17. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The $1,000 penalty will be imposed for agenda item 17. Calling agenda item 18, Ufo Cocina Live Cantina. Mr. Kiyuchi.
Again, good afternoon, Madam Chair, members of the Commission, Keith Kiyuchi for licensee. Waive reading of the charge and receive no contest.
Motion to accept the no contest plea.
Second.
It's been moved and second to approve the no contest plea for agenda item number 18. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The no contest plea is accepted.
Mr. Jacob.
This violation occurred on May 28, 2021, where investigators found improper contact tracing logs with failure to keep complete contact tracing logs. Insufficient social distancing between seated goods. This is licensee's first violation of this type. The recommended fine is $500.
Mr. Kiyuchi, any comment?
Both were corrected. The contact tracing laws were changed after the commission investigators appeared and they started implementing proper social distancing.
Thank you. Motion to approve the recommended fine of $500 for agenda item 18.
Second.
It's been moved in second to approve the recommended fine of $500 for agenda item number 18. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The $500 penalty will be imposed for agenda item number 18. Thank you, Mr. Kiyuchi.
Thank you.
Calling agenda item number 19, Yukaku.
Hello, my name is Todd Nakamura. I'm the area manager for Yukaku Kapuma.
Thank you. Mr. Jacob, can you please read the charges?
Charge 1. Owner about October 16, 2021 in the city of Honolulu, state of Hawaii. Licensee failed to comply with any other laws applicable to the business of licensee, whether in existence at the time of issue of such license or enacted or amended from time to time thereafter. To wit, proclamation of emergency order number 2021-14, COVID-19, novel coronavirus, dated October 8, 2021, in violation of section 281-38 of the Hawaii Revised Statutes. Charge 2. On or about October 16, 2021, in the city and county of Honolulu, state of Hawaii, one or more Honolulu liquor commissioners investigators were threatened with use of violence, force, physical interference, or obstacle, were hindered, obstructed, or prevented from entering into licensee's premise, or were opposed, obstructed, or molested in the performance of their duties, whether by the licensee, licensee's employer, or any other person, to wit, attempted to conceal evidence in violation of section 281-79 of the Hawaii Revised Statutes.
Mr. Nakamura, how would you like to plead to charge 1?
No contest.
And how would you like to plead us to charge 2?
No contest.
Motion to accept the no contest, please, for Agenda item 19, charges 1 and 2.
Second.
Okay, before we proceed, just have the record reflect. I believe we have a Mr. Uno online as well. Can you introduce yourself for the record for your appearance? Dylan. You're on mute.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, I'm Dylan Uno, the manager of the Populani.
Okay, thank you.
The manager on duty at the time of the violations.
Okay, thank you. Motion to, I'm sorry. It's been moved in second to approve, to accept the no contest plea for charges 1 and 2 for agenda item number 19. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The no contest plea for charges 1 and 2 are accepted.
Mr. Jacob, can you provide your recommendations, please?
Both of these charges occurred on October 16, 2021. Charge 1 involved the licensee selling, offering to serve, or consuming alcohol after the hours, which were prohibited by the mayor's order. Charge 2, investigators showed up, the doors were locked, and bottles of alcohol were removed from the bar before letting investigators in. Charge 1 is a first violation. The recommended fine is $500. However, the licensee had received a previous warning on August 13, 2021. Charge 2 is also a first violation. The recommended fine is $1,000.
I'm sorry, can you repeat your recommendation? You're recommending fine for charge 1?
$500.
Thank you. Mr. Nakamura, do you have any comments as to these charges?
No comment.
Okay. The second charge, the obstruction charge, is a serious violation. And it's been stated by the prosecutor that you or your employees removed items or bottles before allowing investigators onto the premises. And that to me is not okay. So, if you were on duty at the time, this shouldn't have happened. As soon as the investigators come to the premises, they need to be there on immediately. There should be nobody standing in their way, no locked doors. So if this is a first time violation for that type of violation, and I will warn you folks that if we see something like that again, it could be grounds for a suspension or revocation of the license. Okay, we're working in partnership here to keep the public safe, and that means that when our investigators arrive, they are given access to the premises immediately, okay?
Yes, understood.
Thank you. Motion to approve the recommended fine of $500 for charge 1, as well as the recommended fine of $1,000 for charge 2.
Second.
It's been moved in second to approve the recommended fine of $500 for charge 1 and $1,000 for charge 2, with a total assessed penalty of $1,500. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The total penalty of $1,500 will be imposed for agenda item number 19. Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Understood. Very sorry, it won't happen again.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Uno. Okay, moving on to agenda item number 20, Hank's Cafe, Honolulu. Hi.
Cafe Ann Swan-Khan here for Hank's Cafe.
Are you authorized to appear on their behalf? Are you a manager or authorized agent?
Yes. James sent the email this afternoon.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Mr. Jacob.
On or about October 16, 2021, in the city and county of Honolulu, state of Hawaii, licensee failed to comply with any other laws applicable to the business of licensee, whether in existence at the time of issue of such license or enacted or amended from time to time thereafter. To wit, proclamation of emergency order number 2021-14, COVID-19, novel coronavirus, dated October 8, 2021, in violation of section 281-38 of the Hawaii revised statutes.
Ms.
Swan-Khan,
how would you like to plead?
No contest.
Motion to accept the no contest plea.
Second.
It's been moved in second to accept the no contest plea for agenda item number 20. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The no contest plea is accepted for agenda item 20.
Mr. Jacob, your recommendation.
This violation occurred on October 16, 2021, where investigators noticed no social distancing between customers, not wearing masks, customers intermingling, as well as customers standing at the bar. This is licensee's third violation. The recommended fine is $1,000. The first violation occurred on April 29, 2020. The licensee paid $500. The second violation occurred on April 8th, 2021. The licensee paid $500. The licensee has also had two prior warnings. One warning on May 5th, 2021, and a second warning on August 25th, 2021. Again, this is licensee's third violation. Recommended fine is $1,000.
And Mr. Jacob, according to your records, was Heights Cafe Honolulu subject to a 24-hour shutdown in response to these violations initially?
I will leave the licensee's comment.
I was in here, but I believe twice. I know for sure twice we were closed for 24 hours.
Yeah, so I've had a chance to review the investigative report, and they were shut down for 24 hours.
Both times previously?
Unfortunately, I do not have that information in my file. I only have the information regarding this third violation.
Thank you. Commissioners,
what's going on?
Last year?
No, pertaining to all these violations with the violations that you're having, and now this is the third one. Is there a problem with wearing masks? Is there a problem with enforcement in your bar? What's happening?
I'm usually not there. I'm just here. Sorry.
Okay, so maybe Mr. Tengman or someone else should be here to offer an explanation to the commission, yeah?
Do you want to continue the penalty phase? So, I mean, that is an option.
Okay. The commission may go into executive session to consult with the board's attorney on questions and issues on a matter pertaining to the board's powers, duties, privileges, immunities, and liabilities. I will entertain a motion to go into executive session for this purpose.
So moved.
Second.
It's been moved in second to go into executive session for agenda item number 20. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. We are now in executive session to discuss agenda item number 20. We are back on the record. I will recall the matter, calling agenda item number 20, Hank's Cafe Honolulu.
All right, Ms. Swancon, before I make my motion, I'm disappointed that I don't see your bosses here today for the appearance, and I would like you to make sure that you relay the message to them that we're not happy with these COVID violations. You know, everybody, most of the licensees are taking it very seriously, and a lot of businesses go under due to COVID, so, you know, we want to see you folks taking this seriously. And if you guys come back with a fourth COVID violation, you will be suspend your license, and we don't know how long for. So you should let your bosses know that. With that being said, my motion is to fine Hank's Cafe Honolulu $2,000.
Second.
It's been moved and second to approve the fine of $2,000 for agenda item number 20. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The $2,000 penalty will be imposed for agenda item number 20. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Calling agenda item number 21, Kaneohe Shell Food Mart. Mr. Luke. You're muted, Mr. Luke. Mute. There you go.
Motion to accept the no contest plea for agenda item 21.
Second.
It's been moved and second to accept the no contest plea for agenda item number 21. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The no contest plea is accepted.
Mr. Jacob, your recommendation, please.
This violation occurred when investigators discovered on March 3rd, 2020 that licensee had made changes to the premises without prior permission and approval. This is a licensee's first violation of this type. Recommended fine is $500.
Mr. Luke, any comment?
No comment.
Motion to approve the recommended fine of $500.
Second.
It's been moved in second to approve the recommended fine of $500 for agenda item number 21. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The $500 penalty will be imposed for agenda item number 21. Calling agenda item number 22, Kaneohe Shell Food Mart. Mr. Luke.
Motion to accept the no contest plea for agenda item 22.
Second.
It's been moved in second to accept the no contest plea for agenda item number 22. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The no contest plea is accepted.
Mr. Jacob, your recommendation, please.
This violation occurred on January 7, 2020, when the licensee transferred to another person without prior approval. This is licensee's first violation. Recommend the fine is $500.
Mr. Luke, any comment?
No comment.
Motion to approve the recommended fine of $500.
Second.
It's been moved and second to approve the recommended fine of $500 for agenda item number 22. Any objections? Any reservation? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The $500 penalty will be imposed for agenda item number 22. Calling agenda item number 23, Kaneohe Shell Food Mart.
Motion to accept the no contest plea for agenda item 23.
Second.
It's been moved and second to accept the no contest plea for agenda item number 23. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The no contest plea is accepted.
Mr. Jacob.
This violation occurred on September 11, 2021 and was a result of the ACE project. The employee of the licensee did ask to see the ID. However, the ID was vertical. The employee failed to ask if the individual was 21. This is licensee's first violation. The recommended fine is $1,000.
Mr. Luke.
Employee was suspended, but he quit. So we have one comment.
Motion to approve the recommended fine of $1,000.
Second.
It's been moved in second to approve the recommended fine of $1,000. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, the $1,000 penalty will be imposed for agenda item number 23. Thank you, Mr. Luke. Okay, calling agenda item number 24, Long's Drugs, Mr. Chu.
Yes, good evening, Madam Chair, members of the Commission, Lee Chu on behalf of the licensee. Also appearing with me up on the screen is Adam Wojnarowski, Woynarowski. He is a district leader of Long's in Hawaii. We waive reading of the charge and respectfully plead no contest.
Motion to accept the no contest plea for agenda item 24.
Second.
It's been moved in second to accept the no contest plea for agenda item number 24. Any objections? Any with reservation? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The no contest plea is accepted.
Mr. Jacob.
This violation occurred on August 21st, 2021, and was a result of the ACE project. The employee did not ask if the individual's ID. The employee did not also ask if the individual was 21. This is licensee's first violation within 5 years. Recommended fine is $1,000.
Mr. Chu.
Yes, we apologize for this unfortunate breach of duty by a former employee. We recognize the importance of checking for IDs and making sure everybody's 21 before sale of alcohol is made. The employee is supposed to enter the true correct birthday into the register. We take this action seriously, these types of actions seriously, and the employee in this case was going to meet the breach policy. And we hope that going forward, this will be together.
Thank you, Mr. Chu. Motion to approve the recommended fine of $1,000.
Second.
It's been moved in second to approve the recommended fine of $1,000 for agenda item number 24. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The $1,000 penalty will be imposed for agenda item number 24. Calling agenda item number 25, Long's Drugs.
Good evening, Madam Chair, members of the Commission. We issue on behalf of the licensee, Long's Drugs. To also appearing on behalf of Long's Drugs, district leader, Adam Woynarowski, Woynarowski. We waive reading of the charge and
Motion to accept the no contest plea for agenda item 25.
Second.
It's been moved in second to accept the no contest plea for agenda item number 25. Any objections? Any observations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The no contest plea is accepted.
Mr. Jacob.
This violation occurred on September 4, 2021, and was a result of the ACE project. The employee did ask for ID, however, the ID was vertical. The employee did not ask the individual if they were 21. This is licensee's first violation. The recommended fine is $1,000.
Again, Mr. Chu.
It's an unfortunate incident here. The employee did check for the ID, however, did not put in the correct birth date into the cash register for the sale. Way was terminated, and apologize for that. And it was a republication of the policy from the store, and we hope that this doesn't happen again.
This is your folks' new location in Waianae, correct?
Yes, not a cool new store.
Okay, I'll remind you that at that hearing, we did have some pushback from the community in that area regarding this liquor license, and it did have something to do with the underage drinking in the area. So we're disappointed to see that you folks failed this ACE compliance check. and so you said that the employee was terminated, and have you folks done any retraining of the existing, of the remaining employees?
Yes.
A motion to approve the recommended fine of $1,000.
Second.
It's been moved in second to approve the recommended fine of $1,000 for agenda item number 25. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The $1,000 penalty will be imposed for agenda item number 25. Calling agenda item number 26, Long Struts.
Good evening, Madam Chair, members of the Commission. Chair, on behalf of the licensee, Long Struts. To also appearing is District Leader Adam Gori. Wynaroski, sorry, W-O-Y-N-A-R-O-S-K-I. In this manner, we waive reading of the charge and plead no contest.
Motion to accept the no contest plea for agenda item 26.
Second.
It's been moved in second to accept the no contest plea for agenda item number 26. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The no contest plea is accepted.
Mr. Jacob.
This violation occurred on September 4, 2021, and was a result of the ACE project. The employee did not ask for ID, and the employee did not ask the individual if they are 21. This is licensee's first violation. Recommended fine is $1,000.
Mr. Chu, this is the Mililani location, correct?
Yes, this is the Mililani location. It's a long-time store with a really good record, and we were disappointed by this breach of our policy. The employee should have checked the ID for some reason, didn't even ask for ID, and we did the sale, so that employee is terminated, and there's going to be publication of a policy and training by the management staff. And hopefully moving forward, this store will get back to its good record.
Thank you, Mr. Chu. And I know that you've seen us many times before on behalf of this this licensee. As you know, long-time licensee, very trusted in the community. This is my first time seeing you, Mr. Wynaroski, but if you take a look at the dates of these violations, you can see that there's, you know, a time of year that we usually do these checks. There's emails sent out to let you folks know that this is going to be happening, and it's your opportunity to show us that you folks can comply. Okay, so we want to see you folks do better next year. Motion to approve the recommended fine of $1,000 for agenda item 26.
Second.
It's been moved in second to approve the recommended fine of $1,000 for agenda item number 26. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The $1,000 penalty will be imposed for agenda item number 26. Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Okay, calling agenda item number 27, Paradise Cove Luau.
Good evening, Madam Chair, members of the Commission, Newton Chu, on behalf of licensee Paradise Cove Luau. We waive reading of the charge and plead no contest.
Motion to accept the no contest plea for agenda item 27.
Second.
It's been moved in second to accept the no contest plea for agenda item number 27. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The no contest plea is accepted.
Mr. Mr. Jacob, your recommendation, please.
This violation occurred on September 1st, 2021. Investigators saw patrons not wearing masks while walking around, customers and tables not seated 6 feet apart, performers not wearing masks, no social distancing, and self-serve stations for coffee, water, and juice. This is licensee's first violation. Recommended fine is $500.
Mr. Chu.
Yes, on behalf of the licensee, Madam Chair, and members of the commission, we sincerely apologize for this violation. As you know, under the ever-changing COVID rules, it's always difficult for many businesses to interpret the rules properly and then execute on that policy. In this case, having been cited, they committed to do better. They did numerous changes. They removed tables, adjusted the floor space to allow for greater social distancing between guests while seated. They implemented new policies and procedures requiring all guests and employees, including the dancers and entertainers, to wear face covering at all times. Guests were informed through new signage appropriate reminders from staff. All employees were trained in the new policies, and they're told to ask management if there's any questions on interpretation. They did also make changes to the show and choreography to adjust for greater distances between the entertainers, and they took out certain portions of the show that encouraged guests to dance. So, and finally, the self-service coffee and water stations were removed, and since that date, we've had no problems, and we hope that
thank you, Mr. Chu. Motion to approve the recommended fine of $500 for agenda item 27.
Second.
It's been moved in second to approve the recommended fine of $500 for agenda item number 27. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, Chair votes aye. The $500 penalty will be imposed for agenda item 27. Thank you, Mr. Chu.
Okay, thank you.
Moving on to agenda item number 28, White Sands Hotel, Ms. O'Hara.
Good afternoon, Commissioner Christina O'Hara. On behalf of the applicant, with me is Romeo Advinaldo, who's the general manager of the hotel. The names are spelled correctly as they appear on the Zoom. We waive the reading of the charge and plead no contest below.
To both charges?
Yes, correct.
Motion to accept the no contest fees for agenda item 28, charges 1 and 2.
Second.
It's been moved in second to accept the no contest plea for charges 1 and 2 for agenda item number 28. Any objections? Any reservations? See none. Chair votes aye. The no contest plea is accepted for charges 1 and 2.
Mr. Jacob, what is your recommendation?
Both of these violations occurred on October 23rd, 2021. Charge 1 involves investigators seeing employees not wearing masks, customers intermingling while not wearing masks, and gathering at the bar. That's a first-time violation for licensee. The recommended fine is $500. The second charge involves noises emanating from the licensed premises causing undue disturbance. Just as licensee's first violation, the recommended fine is also
$500. All right, Ms. O'Hara, as to charge one, do you have any comment?
Yes, as to charge one, I've spoken with the client. I've impressed upon them the importance of following the orders. They change all the time. I've suggested to them if they need guidance to call the phone numbers and the hotlines. Romeo fully understands that, and we've trained employees so that they know, all the rules inside them.
Mm-hmm. And as to charge two, this was a noise complaint.
And as to charge two, so we have had events since this event in October, so I think we have resolved whatever noise issues there were at that particular event. But the residents in the area know that they may call the premises at any time. They can call the restaurant, and they will address any noise concerns that people have.
Mr. Jacob, do you have any additional details or information on charge two?
Reviewing the investigative report, it indicates that there was a private party event. HPD had already been by twice during the event for noise complaints regarding the music. And then investigators showed up for the
history. I do have one other thing to add about this particular event.
motion to approve the recommended fine of $500 for charge one and $500 for charge two, totaling $1,000.
Second.
It's been moved in second to approve the recommended fine of $500 for charge one and $500 for charge two, with a total penalty of $1,000. Any objections, any reservations, seeing none, chair votes aye. The $1,000 penalty will be imposed for agenda item number 28.
Thank you, Ms. O'Hara. Thank you, Mr. Aguinaldo.
Thank you for your time, Commissioner.
Okay, calling agenda item number 29, Workplay LLC.
Hi, this is Rob Rohan, the owner of Workplay.
Mr. Jacob, can you please read the charges?
November 30th, 2020, licensee failed to timely submit the name of every person then employed on the license premise to his registered with the commission or is subject to registration on the date and in such manner as directed by the commission, in violation of Rule 3-82-38.8 of the rules of the Liquor Commission of the City and County of Honolulu.
Mr. Hasha, how would you like to plead?
No contest.
Motion to accept the no contest plea.
Second.
It's been moved in second to accept the no contest plea for agenda item number 29. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The no contest plea is accepted.
Mr. Jacob, your recommendation, please.
This is licensee's first violation. Recommended fine is $250.
Mr. Hasha, any comment?
No, I just missed it. I was trying to figure out the story. I really missed it.
Motion to approve the recommended fine of $250 for agenda item 29.
Second.
It's been moved in second to approve the recommended fine of $250 for agenda item number 29. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The recommended fine at $250 will be is assessed for agenda item number 29. Moving on to agenda item number 30, Workplay LLC.
Please introduce yourself again.
Oh, all right, this is Phil Pacheco, owner of Workplay.
Mr. Jacob, the charge, please.
Honor about June 29, 2021, in the City and County of Honolulu, State of Hawaii, licensee failed to comply with any other laws applicable to the business of licensee, whether in existence at the time of issue of such license, or enacted or amended from time to time thereafter, to wit, Chapter 328J, Hawaii Revised Statutes, in violation of Section 281-38 of the Hawaii Revised Statutes.
Mr. Hache, how would you like to plead?
No contest.
Motion to accept the no contest plea for agenda item 30.
Second.
It's been moved in second to accept the no contest plea for agenda item number 30. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. No contest plea is accepted.
Mr. Jacob.
This violation occurred on June 29, 2021 when investigators observed patrons smoking approximately 10 feet from the main entrance. This is licensee's first violation of this type. The recommended fine is $500.
Mr. Hache.
No comment.
Motion to approve the recommended fine of $500 for agenda item 30.
Second.
It's been moved and second to approve the recommended fine of $500 for agenda item number 30. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The $500 penalty will be imposed for agenda item number 30. Calling agenda item number 31, Workplay LLC.
Thank you. Mr. Jacob.
Honor about October 8, 2021, in the City and County of Honolulu, State of Hawaii, licensee failed to comply with any other laws applicable to the business of licensee, whether in existence at the time of issue of such license, or enacted or amended from time to time thereafter. To wit, Proclamation of Emergency Order Number 2021-14, COVID-19 novel coronavirus, dated October 8, 2021, in violation of Section 281-38 of the Hawaii Revised Statutes.
Mr. Hache, how would you like to plead?
No contest.
Motion to accept the no contest plea for agenda item 31.
Second.
It's been moved and second to accept the no contest plea for agenda item number 31. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, chair votes aye. The no contest plea is accepted.
Mr. Jacob.
This violation occurred on October 8, 2021 when investigators observed customers seated less than 6 feet apart, customers intermingling, employees wearing masks below their nose, and standing at the bar. This is licensee's third violation. The recommended fine is $1,000. First look violation occurred on July 10, 2020, where the licensee paid $750. Second violation occurred on August 24, 2020, where the licensee paid $1,000.
Mr. Hache, this is your third violation for violating COVID rules.
professional. It's something that we take very seriously here. Since that time, we've hired additional security, we've hired additional staff. We've got a lot more training. It's a really big challenge for all the patrons to try to tell them what they're doing. Fortunately, this night has happened right as our position for coming off stage. And patrons are trying to talk to them, and it's caused a lot of problems. So we met with all of our assistants and tried to go over protocols. Let them know that they can't stop and talk at tables and try to interview people. We've got to move outside the premises.
Mr. Jacob, was there any previous warnings as well on top of the violations?
I'm not aware of any warnings. The record does not indicate. They have received previous warnings, but not in regards to this matter.
Okay. I would like to say that we were inspected by the police department for the number of 49 projects, and only had three instances of violations.
I'm sorry, Mr. Hasha, did you say 40 times you were inspected?
Yes. We had some neighbor or somebody somewhere to call us every single night. Now, I never entered the premises.
Did you ever have a 24-hour shutdown?
I did. I had it twice. Not the first time, the last time I did. Each time, I combined it cost over $20,000.
I can confirm, Chair, that the licensee was shut down in 24 hours for this issue.
Okay. In the interest of fairness, because this is a third time violation, my motion is to approve a recommended fine of $2,000 for agenda item 31.
Second.
It's been moved and second to approve the fine of $2,000 for agenda item number 31. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, Chair votes aye. The $2,000 penalty will be imposed for agenda item number 31. Thank you. Calling agenda item number 32, 8 Fat Fat, 8 Bar and Grow. Mr. Luke.
Yes, my record reflects my new counsel from the FTC. The waived reading of charges, enter a plea of no contest.
Motion to accept the no contest plea for agenda item 32.
Second.
It's been moved and second to approve to accept the no contest plea for agenda item number 32. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, Chair votes aye. The no contest plea is accepted.
Mr. Jacob.
Forgive me for the ambulance going by. This violation occurred on March 23rd, 2019. Investigators found that the licensee's doors were locked in the front and on the side. This is the licensee's first violation. The recommended fine is $500.
Mr. Luke, any comment?
No comment.
Motion to approve the recommended fine of $500.
Second.
It's been moved and second to approve the recommended fine of $500 for agenda item number 32. Any objections? Any reservations? Seeing none, Chair votes aye. The $500 penalty will be imposed for agenda item number 32. Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Okay, moving on to agenda item number 33, Liquor Administrator, Legislative Update.
I have nothing to add on top of what I reported in the weekly report. Tomorrow is the first lateral deadline, so we expect the bill tracking burden, so to speak, to basically be cut in half after tomorrow, which will be kind of a relief.
Okay.
Not that isn't fun, but.
And then agenda item number 34, Liquor Administrator, Mr. Picaro.
Good afternoon, folks. No administrative matters. Thank you.
Hearing none, meeting is adjourned.